Take it away!
Gather round, children, I shall tell you a tale. This is Adventures in Gaming Episode 4, and we're playing the Oregon Trail. First piece of advice, you want to be a blacksmith. Always be a blacksmith. Or a doctor. They're the best ones. Let's write the names in here. For some reason, this game seems to take up a massive amount of processing power, because it's constantly loading all the time, as you can see with the little leg timer in the middle. Right, so you want to buy all your crap. You can basically buy as much as you like. It's hard to go over the budget buying sensible amounts of things. So just whacking some random numbers and just, you know, try and get as close to the maximum amount of money you can spend as you can. You'll thank me later. Really, why I'm doing this is to prove that this game isn't actually as difficult as people make out, and I'm going to demonstrate that it's quite simple to pretty much coast through the entire game, barely doing anything. I always tend to set off in April or May. I've gone for April this time, for a bit of variation. You can get away with June, just don't pick something stupid like January or December or something. So off we go. So basically, all you have to do really is just sit there and watch. And you got to keep an eye on the little text at the bottom just to make sure you know what's going on. But really, there's never really any major problems. I mean, you get unlucky sometimes, but hey. So you come to the places, you don't actually really need to do anything while you're there. You can just talk to the random people. They never really have anything interesting to say. There's some historical stuff at times. The rest of it is usually just rambling. You can usually get away with floating the wagon across the rivers. Yeah, a bit of a risk, but we like to live dangerously here. So we made it safely, and we continue on our way. You notice that absolutely nothing has happened so far. Well, that's why you want to be a carpenter. You've had a wagon wheel break. We were able to fix it. We lose nothing, even though we had about 20 million spare ones, just in case. The problem with starting in April is you get a lot of cold weather. Like, you get blizzards. A blizzard in April, apparently. There's way too many rivers, you'll notice. Again, just talk to the people, you know. They don't really have much interesting to say. If you have the option, always try and float the thing. Really, just... Oh. Fuck. Oh well. No harm done. Yeah, there's no sound in this game, so I've put a little soundtrack together for you. I tried to pick some appropriate music. I mean, it's hard to find, like, 1800 style music nowadays. So I just picked stuff that had kind of an old-time feel to it. Oh, you've been wrong. So often they take exactly 69 bullets. They don't just take whole boxes. They take individual ones. They're that dedicated. The game is still plentiful along here. We're getting harder to... Oh. You can buy stuff at the fort, so there's no point just wasting your money, because you can go hunting for squirrels. Yay. Die, Bambi. Die. Just take a few down for the hell of it. You can't carry all of it, but whatever. And we got ourselves £145 of food. Keep on trucking. Oh, Nordicon, what are you playing at? Messing with those snakes. You twat. Now we have to rest while you get better. Well, for some reason I've stopped. Like, we really should rest rather than stop, but you know. Well, he'll get better. He better do. I'll fucking kill him. Dick. Anyone like this song? I certainly do. It was in Lost at one point, if I remember correctly. You want to keep an eye on the amount of food you're carrying. You never really need to slow down or speed up the pace, just keep it steady, and you never really need to change the rations either. It'll even itself out, as long as you were sensible with what you bought at the start. And Nordicon's well again, yay! Chimney Rock. Chimney Rock by Moonlight is after... Oh, fuck. I've known yet. Oh, for fuck, I really should spend my time reading what they say. So I can do comical impersonations of really bad 1800s American voices, which I have no skill with at all. We'll get to that later, though. Do gets another four. A lot of the landmarks. Oh, for fuck's sake, Nordicon, you and those fucking snakes. Cock. I didn't see a river by that, but when we were coming up to it. Then we have to arrest, because Nordicon can't stay away from the freaking wildlife. You don't rest too much because you really waste time, and it will get to like the end of the year, and you're basically shagged in the middle of the continent, and not a lot you can do about it. Oh, I wanted to go person hunting. Although you can't hunt in town, but you can hunt like 2 yards away from it. Die, bitch. Come here. Yeah. You can only, with a full load of people, you can only carry 200 pounds of food, but it's always, you know, more entertaining to shoot a whole lot more. Just to make it difficult for everyone else who's travelling. I like to play as competitively. we got some bad water. And no grass. See, one mother of a summer. Oh, fuck the oxen. They can make do. There's some crazy green flashing grass at the bottom. They can eat that. That'll do them some good. Some hair on the chest. The old radioactive grass. Let's go hunting again. Come on. Yeah. Nailed.